Hey guys, Moshe the Electric Israelis here, and thank you for joining my channel. If you're new, please subscribe and help me change the world one electric car at a time. Thank you to all my supporters, Patreons, and in the Tesla earning call the last week, among many topics, Elon Musk really point out the great advantage that Tesla has in terms of battery technology and range, and there is no question about it. Tesla's biggest range is the Tesla Model S Plus. It has the long range plus. It has a rated range of 391 miles. That's great. Now, Elon Musk said, and the EPA now replied to him. Basically, Elon Musk said, and I quote, that someone had left the keys in the vehicle and the door open overnight, causing the Model S to enter into a waiting for driver mode, which caused range estimate to fall below 400 miles. The EPA in response say, EPA spokesman in response say, we can confirm that the EPA tested the vehicle properly, the door was closed, and we are happy to discuss the technical issues with Tesla as we do routinely with all automakers. Okay, so the dispute is this: 400 miles and 391 miles, okay? 9 whopping miles, which basically is, how do I say it without being vulgar, is men arguing about something, okay? Those who understand, understand. This is basically bragging, right? I got 400, and you told me that I have 391, okay? Now, let me tell you about real-world range, which I am declaring myself the expert in the whole world on real-world range, because I drive so much and I test real world range. There is no way you plug in a Tesla from 0 to 100%, let's call it 400 miles. You see, 400 miles. If you drive in real world conditioning, meaning if you need air conditioning, you put it on. If you need heat, you put it on. If you need to go fast, you go faster. If you're on the highway, you drive highway speed plus 5, which is what most people do. Most people do more than that. Real world range, especially in the winter, because I live in a very cold state and I take my long trips usually in the winter, you lose 30% on any electric car. Now, I'm not, God forbid, bashing Tesla. Tesla range, Tesla battery, Tesla charging speed, Tesla charging infrastructure is the best in the world. Without it, I will not be able to do anything with this car. It's fantastic. But real world range, especially in the winter, is usually 30% less. So take 30 miles off of every 100 miles you have shown. Okay? So that's what it is. Now, is it bad? No, it's fantastic. So when I charge this car to 310 miles or 15 miles, whatever I see, and I drive to Florida in the dead of winter, every time I go, you get 30% less driving, real world driving. Now, I can drive 5 miles an hour without the air conditioning and nobody in the car. Okay, maybe I'll get 400 miles when you see 300, really. But that's not real world range. That's not real world anything. Real world range, it doesn't matter which car it is, it's usually 20-30%. Now it's the weather is what? It's going to be 70 degrees today. Beautiful, you get fantastic results in terms of watt hour per mile. You can get maybe 90%, 95% of what it says. But when you average some hot summer with air conditioning and cold winter and anything in between, usually 20%, 10%, 25%, depend, 30% winter. One time it was 30 degrees Fahrenheit here. Okay. Take it back. It was 20 degrees Fahrenheit, New York City. I was in New York City. I got like 45% off the actual range. It's very, there's nothing wrong with that. I'm not blaming anybody. So I'm saying that this argument is argument of two men arguing about size. Let me know what you think. Thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you tomorrow.